With transformative technology and at the Transformative Technology Lab, we're tracking 10 major areas of trans tech. And those 10 areas include things like neurofeedback and biofeedback, neurostim and biostim. Those are the ones that I think people would think of the most. A good example of that would be the Muse headset by Interaxon that measures your EEG, so measures your brain waves. Another thing that's coming out is Neuro Stem. A good example of that would be a company called Halo Neuroscience. And so it's a slight stimulation to the brain that in their trials with elite athletes, they're showing people having big surges in ability. And so that's kind of interesting. There's another product called Think that sits on the forehead right here, and it stimulates the peripheral nerves and sort of could replace a cup of coffee. So it sort of stimulates you and wakes you up. So there's a lot of focus on things that are taking feedback from the body and then stimulating the body. And so it could be the body or the brain. One of the things that is coming is a lot of vagus nerve stimulation. And on the medical side, there's research that's recently come out where people are really taking that more seriously. In addition, some of the things that I think are really cool is I'm really intrigued by emotion recognition software, whether that's through cameras that are watching facial expressions, or another example would be there's a company called Beyond Verbal that just off of the audio files can pick up human emotion. And you might think, well, you know, sort of what's the use of that? I know how I feel. But it's actually, if you think about it, when everything in your house is smart, you're really going to want it to know if you're upset or not. You know, if you're upset or not. So, you know, I have an older friend that I bought an Amazon Echo for, and she whispers around the Echo like it's a real person. This is someone who's in their 70s, and so for people who are growing up in smart houses, which, you know, a lot of children today, they won't even know a time where there isn't a certain level of intelligence that's baked into their environment. We're going to want all these things to know how we feel. I think that emotion recognition is really interesting. It's the thing that's captured my imagination right now. There's a lot of interest right now in neurostim, and a lot of that is based on a series of studies that were done by DARPA, where they were using slight electrical stimulation and saw an increase in task acquisition for people in various roles in the military. The one that's the most well known is for the increase or the acceleration for sharpshooters from novice to expert with the application of a slight electrical stimulation while they were learning. There's a lot of people who are really interested in that. There's actually a really large do-it-yourself community around the world where people are doing citizen independent science, really, and do-it-yourself science and using various levels of electrical currency on their own brains and then sharing it in forums and communicating about it. People have been trying electrical stimulation with physical task acquisition, also language task acquisition. It's one of those things that there's products that are being based on it. There's a whole category of things with called transcranial direct stimulation. And so there's a lot of products out there on that. Some of the brand names that you might find would be Focus is one, Halo Neuroscience is another, the Think product is another. And so it's starting to have commercial products for it. There also was as you can imagine, there's a lot of the medical community is a little concerned about it. It's a good example of where people, individuals are really sort of pushing ahead of where the medical community is on, you know, what's a good idea for what levels of stimulation you should have, how often and where, you know, what part of the brain that you try to stimulate through the surface. And so it's really, it's an interesting space, and people are pushing into it.